Well, good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Welcome to Living Faith Community Church. This is our annual Candlelight service, so thank you for coming. It's just a great way to start off the Christmas season and think about the birth of Christ. As Christians, that's what we celebrate each year, is His birth and the light that brings to our lives, the light that brings to the world. So thank you for coming. My name is Pastor Troy. Welcome. And let's pray together as we begin with song and also word. Heavenly Father, we're grateful that we can gather here in this chapel, thinking about your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, our friend, God in the flesh, came to the world to break through the darkness. That's why we celebrate this candlelight service, to think of the light that He brings to the world, to our hearts. We're so thankful, Father, for the light of your love shown in Jesus Christ, the light of eternal life that comes to each one who believes in Him. And Father, this Christmas, as we gather as family and friends around the tree, around lights, around gifts, we would also remember the birth of Jesus, our Savior, and make much of Him, exalt Him, honor Him for the great things He has done. Long ago, He was born in that stable. An angel sang in the night sky. And Father, as we spend time together tonight, may your Spirit fill us with song to sing of His birth. And we're so grateful for this time together. I pray that your Spirit would fall on us. I pray that your peace would fill our hearts. And we're just so grateful. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah. Thank you. evening. It's good to see you all tonight. The theme of the candlelight service is to bring light into the darkness. It's one of the great titles of Jesus Christ. The prophets used to say that there was darkness over the land, but Jesus Christ was the light that dawned upon the dark land. Because of Christ, we can see truth. We can see that God loves us. We can get a glimpse of eternity. It's great to have the kids and the families here on Christmas.
Baby Jesus.
Yes. We wanted to encourage you this evening with songs of hope, songs that talk about the birth of Christ, songs that talk about the angels who aren't just coming. And this evening, I just wanted to look at a few verses in the Gospel of John. It's really the first chapter, the first few verses. The Apostle John was someone who had a very unique experience with the person of Jesus Christ, God's only Son. The Apostle John was one of the youngest of the disciples. He had this privilege of walking with the author of life, God in the flesh, Jesus Christ. And his gospel that's written in the scriptures has gone out now all over the world through many generations and many times and places. His gospel message about Jesus Christ, many have heard. It's interesting that he starts his letter talking about Jesus Christ being God. He wanted to be sure that the audience who read this, or the audience who heard this preached, would know that Jesus Christ is God, God's Son. Matter of fact, in just the first three verses, he talks about Jesus being the living Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the very beginning. In the very beginning of what? The very beginning of human history. The very beginning of the dawn of time. Jesus Christ was there with the Father, creating the universe, creating the world, making Adam and Eve in his own image. We are the image bearers of God. What's important to know about Jesus Christ is that he was not only God's Son, and in the beginning with the Father, but he was also the one who brought light to mankind. In verse 3, it says here, "In him we have life, and that life was the light of the world, the light of all mankind." And as I reviewed these verses this week, I saw that the Apostle John starts off by saying, in the beginning was this Word, this living Word, this revelation, this person of Jesus Christ. And he was with God. He was with God, his Father. He was not only with God, but he says here that the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Verse 2, he was with God, and through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. So in the first two sentences, the Apostle John would say to the world, would say to us tonight, and I get to be the herald of this truth, is that Jesus Christ was the living Word. And he was with his Heavenly Father at the dawn of time. And he was not only with God, but he was God. And all things were created by him. And nothing that has been made has not been made other than by him. This is something John wants us to know as he approaches the gospel message and talks about Christ and his coming. He was the light of the world. He was God himself. He was the Word of God. And when I looked up that phrase, the Word of God, it's not only with God, but the Word of God. The word is logos. It was a common known word back at that time. It was a common language term to let people know that God is wanting to communicate with you. And so when Jesus came, he was going to be God's living Word to us, God's communication to us. In the context of what John is saying, it means that he was God's living, breathing revelation to us. And indeed, when Christ was born that night, he was a living revelation that God was now in the presence of mankind. And it says that he would be the light, not only the living Word of God, not only the Creator with God the Father at the beginning of time, but he was the light of all mankind, the light that shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Christ, the light, shining in the darkness. Now, the original language, our English doesn't do it very good justice. In the original language, it means living, oppressive darkness. It means spiritual darkness. The prophets would say things like Isaiah and Micah. They would say, in the land of darkness, there has dawned a great light. And they were talking about Jesus Christ. They were predicting Jesus Christ. And now here John picks up on that and says, this light has dawned, dispelling the darkness. And the darkness can't overcome it. Whenever you light a candle or turn on a light, the darkness is dispelled. And that's the whole reason why God the Father sent his Son, Jesus Christ, born of the Virgin Mary, born to Joseph in the line of David, born in the city of David, Bethlehem, late that night. You know, when they entered Bethlehem, the place was crowded because there was a census going on and they had no room to acquire. So Joseph and Mary, this young Jewish couple, they found a place in a stable on the street. They thought it was a cave. So here is Joseph and Mary, and Mary was all of 15 or 16. She's fully pregnant with the Son of God. And her husband Joseph was probably quite a few years older, and they've been traveling all day on this donkey on a dirt, rocky road. They were exhausted, they were wiped out, and all they could find was a stable where the animals were. The ox, the cow, the sheep, the goat. The place was rough, place was dirty, place was smelly. And God the Father and Jesus Christ, the Creator of all things, was with the Father at the dawn of time, now coming to be the light of the world. On Christmas Eve, on that Nativity night, he's born in a stable barn with smelly animals. Why would God allow that to happen to his Son? This living Son, who John says was with him at the beginning of time, and is the Creator of all things, and is the light of mankind, because God the Father wanted his Son to be born in a humble, impoverished way, so that he could relate to us. And it was interesting that night that not only was God's Son being born in the flesh and put in this stable trough of hay where animals fed, and I'm sure that he glowed in his eyes and in his spirit with the spirit of his Father, the love and peace of his Father. You know, Christ is called by the prophets and the apostles the Prince of Peace, the Prince of Life. And he came here to give us eternal life. And that's why he was born in that trough, born in that stable, God's Son. You know, that night was full of light. Here is the light of the world, the light of eternity, the light of God's love, born into a little stable trough in a little town of Bethlehem. And that night was full of light. Remember, it was the star above Bethlehem that led the Magi, the wise men, there months later. It was the star that everyone saw up above that little town, up above that stable. Jesus' eyes were full of the light of his Father. There was a heavenly light standing in the night sky. And what happened next? The place broke open with angels, heavenly hosts, and the night sky singing and praising, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill towards men. The Prince of Peace, the light of God's love in his eyes, and a star in the sky, and now angels are singing and lighting up the sky, and the shepherds in that area were terrified, as we read in the account of the Gospel of Luke. What did the angel say to the shepherds? Go into the town of Bethlehem, and you will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And the angel said, He is the Son of God. He is the predicted Messiah. What's Messiah mean? Savior, rescuer. Did we need rescuing? Yes. And that's why 30-some years after Christ's birth, he was nailed to a cross. And that's why we have that lit up. We have this wooden manger, and we have the wooden beams that he was nailed to. He was born in a wooden manger, and he was nailed to wooden beams. Why? Because John says in the third chapter, because God the Father so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son, who was born that night in the stall, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. That's what Christmas is about. That stall, that manger. It's about us receiving everlasting life from God the Father if we believe in his Son. Whoever believes in him shall not perish. You know, when the Father and the Son were at the dawn of time, recorded in Genesis chapter 1, creating the heavens and the earth, do you know what they created on the very first day? Light. They separated the light from the darkness. And they proceeded to make the earth and the sea and all that swims in them and all the cattle and creatures on the land. And then on the sixth day created Adam and Eve in their image. This is the story. This is why Christ came to die, to redeem us. That's why he was born in that little manger stall. Sometimes we look at the nativity, we look at the manger, and we look at Christ being born, but why is that? Why is he there? Why did he come? Why is that important? It's important because it's God's Son. It's important because we need rescue. John says that in him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. And that light shines in the darkness, and the darkness was not able to overcome it. Darkness. That was the little title I gave to this small message. Light breaks through the darkness. The darkness of the world. The darkness of sinfulness or wickedness in your heart. It's a beautiful thing that Christ did when he came. Matter of fact, the scriptures say that the Father sent him. Jesus said of the people when he spoke with them on the earth, he said, the Father has sent me, and I say everything that he's told me to say. And I've come here for you, that you might have eternal life. This is the great message I want to share with people at Christmas time, if I have an opportunity. As professing believers, I would say that to you. Take this Christmas 2023 to share this truth that light has come into the darkness, and the darkness was able to overcome. We look around the world, we look at the news, we see darkness everywhere. What darkness? Violence, brokenness, addiction, immorality, suicide, dysfunction, disease, depression. It's everywhere. John just wasn't talking about the night sky. He was talking about darkness in general in man's heart. And when Jesus Christ came, born of a virgin, born in the flesh, he was born physically, but he came to conquer spiritually. John encourages us later on just to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ as the Son of God, and you will be saved. This is the most important thing to talk about at Christmas or to celebrate at Christmas. I know we have trees, we have lights, we have gifts. Those are beautiful, those are wonderful, those are fun. we should also have a nativity scene and a manger scene in our home or outside our home. And make it known that this is what we really cherish, this is what we really celebrate, this is what we really think of, this is what we're really grateful for at Christmas time. The birth of God's Son. The prophet said, in the land of darkness there's dawn a great light. And that's what happened on that night in Bethlehem. And Jesus had the light of God's love in his eyes. There was a big burning supernatural star in the sky over the manger, and the angels lit up the sky with light and proclaimed to the shepherds. And so the shepherds went into Bethlehem, found the baby in the manger, wrapped in swaddling clothes, and they knelt down. It says that when they left, they couldn't help but tell other people what they'd seen and heard. It's interesting that Jesus would reveal himself first to shepherds, and now centuries later, he reveals himself to normal, blue-collar, everyday shepherds to retell the story 2,000 years later. Pretty amazing. And so tonight, as I close, I would just say to you that look into the manger and see the light of God, the Father's love in the eyes of his Son, Jesus Christ. Remember the night the angel sang and lit up the sky and proclaimed to the shepherds that go into the town of Bethlehem, the town of David, and you'll find God's Son wrapped in swaddling clothes. That's what we celebrate at Christmas, especially as Christians. And so I pray and I hope that this year, as you gather with family and friends, that you remember the Christ child. Remember that he was Jesus Christ, God's Son. Remember that he went to the cross. See, he was born to die. He went to the cross for you. That your sins might be forgiven, all the darkness dispelled. And you can have the light of God's love and eternal peace and hope and joy burning in your heart. It's the best gift God the Father ever gave. He gave it to the world, his only dear Son. As we close our service, I am going to walk down the aisle, lighting candles. So if you grab your candle and stand up, I'm going to come down the aisle and light your candle. And then when everyone's lit, we're going to sing Silent Night. This is a tradition for Living Faith Community Church on this candlelight service celebrating Christmas and the birth of Christ and his light to the world. So if you'll stand with me together and get your candle ready and hold it, I'm going to come down the aisle and light each side, and then you light the person next to you, and everyone's candle will be lit. So we'll end with a beautiful rendition of Silent Night, and then I'll close this in prayer. As we sing the song, and as you look at your candles, in your imagination and in your heart, remember that night that Christ was born. The star in the sky, the angels singing in the night sky, the light of God's love in the eyes of Jesus. Think about that light that breaks through the darkness. That supernatural light can break through any darkness in your heart or your home. I hope that you accept the light of Jesus Christ this Christmas if you've not done that. Thank you.
Thank you.